Okay, engines fired up, we're set.
2019 Geordie's GP was F1's 1000th official championship race. If we continue with around 20 to 24 races a year, we can expect the 2000th GP to happen around the year 2064. World Championship winners. The inaugural World Drivers' Championship was held in 1950 during the fourth season of F1. Giuseppe Farina, who was driving for Alfa Romeo, took the championship after winning three of the seven races held that season. Juan Manuel Fangio also took three victories but lost down points after having retired from the other three races he entered. Max Verstappen became the youngest winner of a GP at just 18 years and 228 days old when he won the 2016 Spanish GP. Coincidentally, he pushed Sebastian Vettel off the top of that record, who came second place in that same race. F1's distinctive sound throughout the decades is in part due to the high-revving engines in use. F1 engines joined the V8 era in the mid-2000s, for example, could reach 19,000 RPM. In comparison, a typical road car won't exceed around 6,000 RPM. It's almost a given that the drivers on the grid today were kart racing as children, so they could enter the sport with as much experience as possible. It hasn't always been like that though. In the 1950s, the average age of the drivers was 39, with three over the age of 50. The Nürburgring is the only F1 track to have hosted three different races: the German Grand Prix, European Grand Prix and Luxembourg Grand Prix. British constructor Arrows never won a race after 383 attempts, the highest of any team in Formula One history. They came close five times in 1978, 1980, 81, 85 and 1997. Ferrari are the only team to have raced in every single season in Formula One. The record for the most cars in an F1 race was achieved at the 1953 German Grand Prix with 34 cars. The race with the fewest entries saw only six cars line up on the grid. This was the infamous 2005 US Grand Prix, which saw 14 cars pulled out of the race due to tyre safety concerns. One of the longest broadcasted races was also one of the shortest. The 2021 Belgian Grand Prix lasted only 3 minutes and 27 seconds, the race being flagged due to wet weather conditions on lap 3. For 2022, the FIA announced that the cars would now be rolling on 18-inch wheels, far larger than 13-inch wheels used prior. These larger tyres were designed to reduce overheating, improve grip and provide more aggressive racing. The United Kingdom has achieved more World Drivers' Championships than any other country, over a quarter of which were won by Lewis Hamilton. Hello to everyone here and welcome, and a special shout out to our VIP guests, Lars Hammer and Arthur Jackman, affectionately known as the Jackhammer. Packed grandstands here today with thousands in attendance, hoping to see their favourite drivers battle it out on track. Let's hope we see a good effort from McLaren here today. In recent times, they've fallen to somewhat of a midfield team. The last time the constructor won a world championship was in 1998. F1's distinctive sound throughout the decades is in part due to the high revving engines. F1 engines joined the V8 in mid-2003.
Thank you.
Verstappen became the youngest winner of GP in 18 years and 228 days old when he won the 2016 Spanish GP. Coincidentally, he pushed Sebastian Vettel off the top of that race. Somewhat of a midfield team. The last time the constructor won a world championship was in 1998. 2014 ushered in a new set of regulations that saw us enter the turbo hybrid era of F1 Cardiff. The biggest change being the engines, which were changed from 2.4 litre V8 engines to 1.6 litre turbocharged V6 power units. Along with this came integrated complex digital systems such as ERS. Welcome, and a special shout out to our VIP guests, Lars Hammer and Arthur Jackman, affectionately known as the Jackhammer. Sebastian Vettel holds the F1 record for the shortest time elapsed before picking up a penalty. He was caught speeding in the pit lane in practice for the 2006 Turkish Grand Prix almost immediately after he exited the garage, just 9 seconds into his F1 career. The inaugural World Drivers' Championship was held in 1950 during the fourth season of F1. Giuseppe Farina, who was driving for Alfa Romeo, took the championship after winning 3 of the 7 races held that season. Juan Manuel Fangio also took 3 victories but lost out points after having retired from the other 3 races he entered. If you don't know, the tubular safety device that sits over the driver's head, aptly named the Halo, is constructed out of titanium and adds roughly 9 kilograms to the car's total weight. Max Verstappen became the youngest winner of a GP at just 18 years and 228 days old when he won the 2016 Spanish GP. Coincidentally, he pushed Sebastian Vettel off the top of that record, who came second place in that same race. Formula 1 is named as such because the participants agree to a set of rules where the formula are the rules and the one referring to the fact that this is the top tier of motor racing. Max Verstappen managed to finish 81% of his races on the podium in 2021. Still though, Michael Schumacher holds the record for highest percentage when in 2002, Schumacher finished on the podium in every race he participated in, making it 100%. For 2022, the FIA announced that the cars would now be rolling on 18-inch wheels, far larger than 13-inch wheels used prior. These larger tyres were designed to reduce overheating, improve grip, and provide more aggressive racing. Sebastian Vettel holds the F1 record for the shortest time elapsed before picking up a penalty. He was caught speeding in the pit lane in practice for the 2006 Turkish Grand Prix almost immediately after he exited the garage, just 9 seconds into his F1 career. I'm not superstitious, but in the long and fruitful history of F1, no one with the surname Hill has ever failed in winning a world title. For example, example, Graham Hill, Damon Hill and Phil Hill are all previous World Championship winners. The record for the most cars in an F1 race was achieved at the 1953 German Grand Prix with 34 cars. The race with the fewest entries saw only 6 cars line up on the grid. This was the infamous 2005 US Grand Prix, which saw 14 cars pulled out of the race due to tyre safety concerns. The Nürburgring is the only F1 track to have hosted 3 different races: the German Grand Prix, European Grand Prix and Luxembourg Grand Prix. Max Verstappen became the youngest winner of a GP at just 18 years and 228 days old when he won the 2016 Spanish GP. Coincidentally, he pushed Sebastian Vettel off the top of that record, who came second place in that same race.
Set of regulations that saw us enter the turbo hybrid era.
Thank you.
Our best lap so far is a 1:18.1.
German Grand Prix, European Grand Prix, and Luxembourg Grand Prix. The record for the most cars in an F1 race was achieved at the 1953 German Grand Prix, 34 cars. The race with the fewest entries saw only 6 cars line up on the grid. This was the infamous 2005 US Grand Prix, which saw 14 cars pulled out of the race due to tyre safety concerns. Formula 1 is named as such because the participants agree to a set of rules where the formula are the rules and the one referring to the fact that this is the top tier of motor races. Let's hope we see a good effort from McLaren here today. In recent times they've fallen to somewhat of a midfield team. The last time the constructor won a world championship was in 1998. Max Verstappen became the youngest winner of a GP at just 18 years and 228 days old when he won the 2016 Spanish GP. Coincidentally, he pushed Sebastian Vettel off the top of that record, who came second place in that same race. The inaugural World Drivers' Championship was held in 1950 during the fourth season of F1. Giuseppe Farina, who was driving for Alfa Romeo, took the championship after winning 3 of the 7 races held that season. Juan Manuel Fangio also took 3 victories, but lost out points after having retired from the other 3 races he entered. I'm not superstitious, but in the long and fruitful history of F1, no one with the surname Hill has ever failed in winning a world title. For example, Graham Hill, Damon Hill and Phil Hill are all previous world championship winners. Packed grandstands here today with thousands in attendance, hoping to see their favourite drivers battle it out on track. For 2022, the FIA announced that the cars would now be rolling on 18-inch wheels, far larger than 13-inch wheels used prior. These larger tyres were designed to reduce overheating, improve grip and provide more aggressive racing. Present since the very start of the sport, Ferrari takes the number one spot for almost all constructor records in F1. It's the team with the most world championships won, the most Grand Prix wins, most pole positions, and most race entries. The record for the most cars in an F1 race was achieved at the 1953 German Grand Prix, 34 cars. The race with the fewest entries saw only 6 cars line up on the grid. This was the infamous 2005 US Grand Prix, which saw 14 cars pulled out of the race due to tyre safety concerns. British constructor Arrows never won a race after 383 attempts, the highest of any team in Formula One history. They came close 5 times in 1978, 1980, 81, 85, and 1997. Sebastian Vettel holds the F1 record for the shortest time elapsed before the Turkish Grand Prix.
We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those...